Bande Guru Padadandam Bhakta Binda Samannitam Sri Chaitanya Prabhum Bande Nitta Ananda Sahoditam Sri Nanda Nandanang Bande Radhika Charanodayam Gopijano Samayuktam Binda Vanam Manoharam Vāñśā-kalpa-taru-vaśya-ke-pāsindu-vivacha Patitānaṁ-pāvune-bha-vaiṣṇa-vibhyo-namo-namaha Mūkhaṁ-karoti-vācālaṁ-pangum-laṁ-haiti-giriṁ Yat-ki-pātam-haṁ-bandhi-paramānanda-mādhavam Vṛndāvai-tūsi-devvai-piyāvai-kesa-vaśya-ca Sna-bhakti-pade-devi-sattva-vattvai-namo-namaha Narayana-namaskritta-narun-caiva-narottama Devin-svara-svati-vyasam-tato-jayo-deva Saṅkīrtane-krishna-kathopadeshe Gauriya-patrasya-prakāsa-necha Sadhanurakta-guru-bhakti-yukta Bhakti Pramodakshya Jagod Bharanya Deyam Sadapari Bhavagnam Abhishchaduham Tethas Padam Siva Viranchanutam Saranyam Vittatiham Panatopal Bhavadiputam Bande Mahapurusate Charuna Ravindam Yat pad pallavanaka chandamani chatai Vishpurjitakma bhikapavadushvadarashi Purnanuragra sasagra saramuti Saradhikami kadakvam karuti Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhunitananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadi Gaura Bhakta Binda Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Sivasadihi Gaura Bhakta Binda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Ajānulambita bhujau kanukā budhātu Saṅkītanai kapitaru kamalāyatākṣo Vishāmbarau jyabarau jugadharma pālau Bande yagat priyakarau karunā bhatārau Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. Namami Gange Tava Padu Pankajam Sura Surair Bandito Dibbarupam Bhuktiṃ ca muktiṃ ca dadāsinitam Bhāvānurūpena sadā narānam Gangā taranga ramaniya jatā kalāpam Gauri nirantara vibhuṣito bhāma bhāgam Nārāyano priyamananga madā puhāram Varanasipurapati bhajavishanatham Vagisha jushya badane Lakshmir jasya chavakshashi Jasyasthide sambhi Tvam nishingamaham bhaji Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Bhakti hi parishan bhava virakti ranatra chaisho triko eka kalaha prapadyamanasya yathasnataha Sutushti pushti khudu payo anughasam bhakti parishanubhavo virakti ranatra chaishatriko ekakalaha prapadyamanasya yathasnataha sutushti pushti khudu payo anughasam Gauriya Goshthipati Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told, nothing is more auspicious than Acharya Puja, Acharya Seva. Gauriya Goshthipati, Sisila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagadguru told, nothing is more auspicious than Acharya Seva, Guru Seva. We cannot compare anything with Sadguru Seva, Acharya Seva. But common people, they are in confusion about this Tattva Vigyan, which Tattva, how to select, what kind of quality should be there in Acharya, who is in search of Acharya. If we at all interested to know the Absolute Truth, if we are at all, you know, going to show honest sincerity, honest inquiry about Acharya Tattva, Guru Tattva, without any fighting mood, then surely, by the mercy of Balaji Maharaj, we can get it, no doubt. Many times before, I was bound to discuss this point, that by the manifestation of the unique eternal Acharya Siv of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, Jagadguru, all other so-called acharyaship become, you know, fake. We can come to know that all useless, you know, unauthentic, not authentic, no authenticity is there. This way we can detect, we can understand gradually. So nothing is more important, nothing is more auspicious than Acharya Seva. And how to know Bhagavata Tattva Vigyan, how to know Bhagavata Tattva Vigyan, there is already standing instruction given by Krishna, Bhagavan Sri Krishna, to Uddhavji Maharaj. But we are less interested to know all in details about this. Bhagavan Sri Krishna already told that Tatro Bhagavatana Dharamana Sikshet Gurvatma Devataha Amaya Yano Britva Joyas to Shed Atma Atmodohari. If you are going to follow exact Bhagavad Dharma, exactly from heart, then Supreme Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, or Bhagavan Sri Krishna, same thing, going to sell himself in front of you. That's why Nityananda Prabhu used to speak, Amare kiniya laho bhajo gauro hari. You can buy me. Many times Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his Chaitanya Charitamrita, here you can find, many times, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, I am sold to him. I am already sold to him. What can be the reason? So it is written that Tatra Bhagavatana Dharamana Sikshet. You have to learn Bhagavad Dharma, get detailed information from an authentic source, Sadguru Acharya, who is a practicing Acharya, and whose Acharya Siv is eternal Acharya Siv, not for some for certain period he is going to exhibit Acharya Joseph, not that. So Bhagavad says, Tatra Bhagavatana Dharmana Sikshet Guruvatma Devataha Amayaya Anuvritva. Amayaya Anuvritva. Amayaya means there should not be any duplicity, no maya, illusion, darkness. No. Amayaya. Without taking help of any maya. Totally. You'll have to cut. Amayaya. You like to cut at least. Sincerity. Amayaya Anuvritva. Anuvritva means you'll have to, in toto, you will have to follow in a sautopantha. Amayaya Anuvritta. Not that you can jump and cross, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Guru Varga and try to achieve something new, which is absurd, to get name and fame all over the world. So, you see, Amayaya Anuvritta. Jai Tushed Atma Atmado Hari. So, if you are successful to follow this procedure, I mean, Gurvanugatva, I mean, in toto you are going to, you are interested, you are honest inquiry, no problem. Panipat, Parivishnu, Seva, it's okay. In that case, Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, become very happy with you. Very happy with you. Ultimately, when you are successful, to digest, you know, to realize this Bhagavad Dharma, a full of, you know, prema. In that case, Bhagavad Dharma means, because the ultimate goal of Bhagavad Dharma is to get prema. Prema pumatho mahano. Bhagavad Dharma is Bhagavad Dharma. So in that case, Bhagavan like to sell himself in front of you, become very happy with you. Jaistu shed atma atmado hari. Bhagavan Supreme Lord become very happy with you. Even he like to sell himself in front of you. Sell himself means, actually we know that nobody can control, nobody can get control over Supreme Lord. But that Supreme Lord, out of prema, like to be controlled by devotees, you know. In that case, it's a unique thing, very, very beautiful. In that case, you see, Aham bhakto paradhino hi asatantra iva diyo. This kind of word, Bhagavan Sri Krishna himself speaking, that's mean Bhagavan like to be controlled by pure devotees. That's why we will have to approach a Sadguru. We'll have to take shelter of a bona fide Sadguru who is full of prema, from a full of tattva-gyan. In that case, our you know, prayer, our, you know, request, our prayer can reach up to the lotus feet of Supreme Lord through Guru Vaishnava. Vaishnavero abhidanne Krishna dayamoy eheno pamorpati hoiben sadai. So, first of all, the unique acharyaship of Prabhupada, and we are very interested to know all secrecy about Acharya Tattva, Guru Tattva, whom to take shelter, how to take shelter, and what should be my quality before taking shelter. All those, you know, things from different angles we are very interested to discuss, actually. So, actually, why Prabhupada wanted to speak that way, that Acharya can never be elected, only, you know, Acharya is self-manifested tattva, automatically. I like to discuss all this point. But before that, you must understand this point, actually. In front of Uddhavji Maharaj, Bhagavan Sri Krishna was bound to speak. Tasmat guru prapaddeta jigyasu sreya uttamam. Sabde parechan isnatam brahmani upasamasrayam. Tasmat guru prapaddeta. Tasmat, I mean, before Bhagavan giving so many arguments, after the speaking, this is the condition, Tasmat Guru Prapaddeta, that's why, Tasmat Guru Prapaddeta Jigyasu Sreya Uttamam. If you have at all honest inquiry about that Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan, absolute truth, In that case, if you are busy with position, rank, glamour, then you need not hear my Harikatha. What you can do hearing? You know. So that's why it is written, if you are at all very interested, if you have, you know, honest inquiry about that Bhagavad Tattva Vijnana Absolute Truth, in that case, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking to Uddhav, to Uddhavji Maharaj, Tasmad Guru Prapadyata Jigyasu Sriyam Uttamam. Jigyasu, who has inquiry, honest inquiry, Jigyasu Sriyam Uttamam, Sriyam Uttamam, which is an absolute question. There can be so many questions. You can have logical, you know, interpretation, you can have some, you know, argument, you know. That's I am not speaking. But honest inquiry, honest, you know, interrogation, you know. Jigyasu Sriyam Uttamam. So what is the symptom Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking? The symptom is Sabde Paricha Nishnatam Brahmani Uposamasrayam. Shabda Brahma and Parabrahma, Nishnatam and totally verse. Totally. Shabda Brahma, he is having full realization about Shabda Brahma. And Parabrahma also full realization through his seva. Many times I told on those days before, you know, many times. That the symptom of a unique acharya, the symptom of an acharya is his unique seva mood, eternal seva mood is the symptom, nothing else. And in the character, in the behavior, in the advice, in the acharan of a perfect acharya, we cannot find out any question of jivhingsa. Jivhingsa can be done in different ways. So we will have to discuss in details, but not today. How different way, you know, we can go for jivhingsa. This is very important point. Especially under the guidance of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we have the chance. All other sampradayas, they don't have such a clear idea. They have some idea, but not so clear. As in Saraswat Gaudiya Sampradaya, we are having this kind of conception that even if I am not going to guide you properly, going to speak you wrongly, to protect my love, puja, patishta, sweet way, with sweet glance, in that case it is jivhingsa. Except bhakti, if I am going to speak something else, if I am going to advise you about jnana, yoga, it also can become dry jnana. It can also become, but if you do it, as per in Bhagavad, Srimad Bhagavad Mahapuran, Bhagavan Sri Krishna already giving advice, that some, you know, bhakti yoga is allowed, and pranayama, etc. also allowed in Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, but it should not be done simply to keep your body fit. Follow? You should have a link with bhakti. If you are interested about bhakti, okay, as a primary, primary result, you are automatically going to, you know, secondary result, you can get it. But not that it is you are going to fast Ekadashi, you are doing just with a conception, with one conception that I can, if I go for fasting, then my health, I can develop my health. This is very bad. It's not good. Automatically you can get some facility, that's different. But main point should be bhakti. If your main point is not bhakti, then it's very dangerous. It's not good actually. So Shabde Parichan is Natam and Brahmani Uposamasrayam. Shabda Brahma and Parabrahma, words in Shabda Brahma. Because if he is not, my Acharya is not words in Shabda Brahma, how he can advise me, how he can cut my doubts, everything, you know? That's why, you know, Shabda Brahma and Parabrahma, both. But suppose some Paramahansa Vaishnava is there, like Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj. Externally, you can find you as he is not going to speak all Harikatha, all different kind of scriptural lines, not going to speak, but we can find, we can see very clearly, if there is no jealousy, no envious attitude inside heart, as we can clearly understand, though Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj not going to speak in front of you all, Shastriya Vichar, everything, but in each and every advice of Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj was based on Shuddha, scriptural analysis, no doubt. He is going to speak all clearly, very, all on the basis of all Shastra. So, Shabda Brahma, specially Harinam, don't try to express any doubt about Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj. Shabda Brahma means Ananta Param Kila Sabda Shastram. Okay, we know. But Shabda Shastra all coming from the original source, that is Mahamantra. Okay, na? It's Mahamantra. Or Brahmaksha Ekaksharam Brahma Mantra, Omkar Artho, also, same. So, Mahamantra actually is the original source of everything. It's going to indicate Radha Govinda totally inside this mantra. So, in that case, Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj is totally established in Harinam. That's why we in Pranam Mantra speaking, the Paramahansa Acharya Bharjo. Paramahansa Acharya Bharjo, for other Paramahansa, because Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj specially, his activities, his acharan going to establish so many things, going to establish so many facts and figures, so many. That's why our Guru Varga writing this Pranam Mantra, Paramahansa Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj, Acharya Bharjo, Paramahansa Acharya Bharjo. He is Paramahansa at the same time, Paramahansa base, not going for preaching in the field, but still, Acharya Bharjo. Because Acharya Bharjo means topmost Acharya. Because each and every time, his achar, acharan, everything, he was not interested only with his bhajan. Many times, so many, if I discuss his Abhirbhaptiti, Tirabhaptiti, I can discuss, we can show him. Unique, his acharan, everything, can expose all the mystery of Hari Bhajan. So we see, though he is Paramahansa, but still, he is Paramahansa Acharya Bharjo, Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj. And specially, he is Paramahansa, Haridas Thakur is Namacharya. Also, we can say, under the guise of Namacharya, Gaurakishore Das Babaji Maharaj is also Namacharya, all the time doing busy with Harinam. All the time. So, Shabda Brahma originally coming from Mahamantra, and Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj having clear conception about all Shastra Siddhanta. It is tested many times. I told you before, just someday Srila Prabhupada, Bimala Prasad going there. In short, I am touching this point to give you a reminder. You can remember before, I told. That Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj asking to Bimala Prasad, Amar Prabhu, my Prabhu, could you please recite one Bhagavad Sloka? Yes, Srila Vimala Prasad Saraswati is speaking one wise sloka from Bhagavad Mahapuran. Then Srila Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj requesting you, could you please give a nice explanation of this Bhagavad sloka? Yes, why not? Under the guidance of Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj, he is going to explain Bhagavad. So nice explanation. Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj very happy to hear this Satsa Siddhanta and speaking very nice, very nice. Very nice. Acha, my Prabhu, okay, my Prabhu. If I want to explain this sloka this way, is it wrong or right? Then Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj is going to explain the sloka. Srila Prabhupada gone mad. Prabhupada speaking, I cannot imagine even how possible. Externally, we see Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj not sitting in reading any Shastra, Siddhanta, nothing, anything. But how it is possible for Babaji Maharaj, Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj, to explain this Bhagavad Sloka that way, unique way? unique way of explanation. Prabhupada was very stunned. Prabhupada was stunned to hear the explanation. So this way many times it was tested inside the heart of Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj. Gaur Kishor is always sitting inside heart. Prabhupada speaking, Gaur Kishor, Gaur Kishor, the Supreme Lord, Gaur Kishor, always sitting inside the heart of Gaur Kishor Das Babaji Maharaj. So there can be no shortage of any knowledge. There cannot be any shortage of any explanation. All, infinity knowledge. Jasmin gyatye sarvamidam vigyatam bhavati. Jasmin prapte sarvamidam praptum bhavati. After achieving which, you are not going to express any dissatisfaction. After achieving which, you are not going to express any dissatisfaction. I mean, you are totally satisfied. After knowing which, there is nothing shortage in your bandara, in your bandar, the storage of knowledge. There is no shortage. That is called this way explanation. We want to explain this sloka. Shabde parichani snatam brahmani upasamasrayam. Specially, our Tattacharya Jiva Goswami speaking, Shabde parichani snatam, this sloka, Sri Jiva Goswami speaking. If Acharya cannot explain Shastra, if I am going to put some question, in that case, suppose he is not going to give me proper explanation of my question, interrogation. In that case, that disciple can express some doubts. Oh, my Gurudev is not knowing anything about Shastra properly. In that case, that disciple can fall down. Because bonded soul is always sceptic-minded. Bonded soul is always full of, doubts. Full of doubts, suspicion, doubts, everything. From different angles we are going to give explanation, different angle. But still, sometimes some suspicion, some inquiry coming. Okay, it's very good. But if, Srila Jiva Goswami speaking, if that disciple not going to get proper answer of his question, in that case he can express doubts about his Guru Tattva, Acharya Sif. In that case, maybe the Acharya is good, but he is not habituated to explain Shastra that way. So in that case, there can be some problem. So, Shabde Parichani Snatam Brahmani Upasamasrayam. Brahmani Upasamasrayam means Brahmani Upasamasrayam. He is totally balanced. Totally balanced means totally satisfied, saturated. There is no disturbance inside heart. There is no disturbance inside heart. No dissatisfaction. Nothing is totally satisfied. So, it's totally satisfied. It's called Sabde Parichanisnatam Brahmani Uposamasrayam. Uposam means actually remedy. Uposam, Uposamasrayam. Uposam Asrayam, Uposamasrayam. I mean under the shelter of Sadguru, Vaishnava, Bhagavan, we can get that kind of total satisfaction. Separately, by your personal effort, you cannot attain this stage of saturation. By your personal effort, you can never attain this stage of saturation. It's not possible. Only and only by the mercy of Sadguru, Vaishnava, it is possible for you. Srila Prabhupada speaking, before achieving perfect power in bhajan, kipa karo prabhu diya chidbal. We are singing in kirtan, Prabhupada speaking, before attaining that kind of powerful stage of bhajan, in that case, if that devotee not going to think about satsanga, okay, it's no problem, it can be there. It's one kind of adjustment, dirty adjustment with bhakti, bhakti vinodhara and non-bhakti vinodhara. Prabhupada speaking, sadhan rajye in your bhajan field, until and unless you are going to attain that perfection, I mean big power, chitbal properly. Like, I can give one example. Ajamil was doing Gayatri Mantra, everything. Ajamil was very honest boy, honest man. He had respect for seniorly, you know, father, mother, all, everything. But chitbal was not sufficient with Ajamil. The only reason there was no sufficient chitbal was not there with Ajamil. That's why he was bound to fall down. He was very good, nice man, character, nice, everything. So what? That's why Prabhupada told you, in the way of Hari Bhajan, moral character, you know, material idealism, all useless. Krishna Bhajan is so high, so high, so high, I cannot play with you all with this Krishna Bhajan. I am idiot, but not such a great idiot to play with you about Krishna Prema, Sahajiya, Krishna Prem, Krishna Bhajan. I cannot play, because this is a question of my survival, this is a question of your survival, and the overall we have to think about the whole Sampradaya situation of whole Sampradaya. It is the duty of all Gauriya devotees, all those who are genuine devotees. I can discuss all. So, sabde paricha nisnatam brahmani upasamasam, you should realize it. After that, Prabhupada speaking, that before attaining that kind of perfection stage, if you have no idea, no conception about it is bad satsanga, it is asatsanga, is no upalabdhi realization. Why there is no realization? No sincerity is not there. You are not enjoying keep up Guru Vaishnava. I am 100% sure. 100%. You know, if you are going to enjoy full keep up of pure Guru Vaishnava, automatically, maybe you are not educated, but still automatically you can have that kind of realization, that kind of sensitivity. You can detect this is wrong, this is right, automatically. And so, Prabhupada speaking, before attaining this kind of, full right in bhajan, if those devotees, they are not going to think about satsanga, asatsanga, no realization, then he will have to go back and back and back and back. Because automatically there is the possibility of aparat, and those devotees, they are going to lose their realization power gradually. Asasanga means 100%. You are going to lose your consciousness, realization power. At the same time, there is every possibility to make aparad. Because asasanga means asasanga, there is no conception. So surely you are going to get aparad and you can fall down. Also, we should take care 100%, because this was the conception of Prabhupada. Now we are playing with this factor. Many times he was bound to speak, but they wanted to, develop some, bitter relation with me. I always wanted to speak this point. In all different mots and mandir, if we cannot apply these rules and regulations set by Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we cannot come out successful. They are going to fight with me, not directly, maybe indirect way, stop my harika, this way. They want to speak that, okay, we should do some adjustment. How it is possible? Adjustment, pure Guru Vaishnava is always adjusted with the whole universe. How dare you speak this way to insult pure Guru Vaishnava? Because you have fallen so. You don't know what do you mean by adjustment, what Prabhupada wanted to speak. In a society, in a mat, mandir, first point, there should be master, proper, acharansil, practicing acharya. If there is no practicing acharya in the mat, if there is each and every mat, if there is no acharansil, Sadhuguru Vaishnava, then that mat become a hostel. This become, this mod become a hostel. We can cook jointly, we can do something, and we can take niceness, paramanno, sweet ball, everything. You can enjoy your life. If there is shortage of acharya, acharya mean who is going to show acharan, going to show acharan in front of you, eternal acharyaship. Okay, also in each and every month there should be acharanshil sadhuguru Vishnu. Under the guidance of that acharya of the whole society, those who are in charge or men sadhu, they are in control of the moth, should apply this principle shown by Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda. If they are going to get deviated, then in infinity period, they cannot come out successful. Only they can make different kinds of moth or mandi, different place, they are going to make garbage. I am not against making moth mandir. What Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to say, that I wanted to remind you. Matmandi dalanbari nakuro prayas. Whereas Popa told that Gauriamat is one kind of spiritual hospital where different kind of patient can come with different kind of disease. Many times Popa told Gauriamat is a prakrit hospital, spiritual hospital, where those bonded souls, they are coming. We should be very careful about giving treatment to different devotees. Maybe some devotees having some, some attraction for women. Some devotees are having some attraction for money, some position, some devotee. These are different kind of disease can be there, or mixed disease. Some woman attraction, some money, this kind of mixed can be there. So in that case, that we can come out successful when, if there is successful acharya in the overall society, he is going to take care of each and every devotee. Even if our Guru Varga was out of sight of Prabhupada, still Prabhupada could see. Suppose some of my Guru Maharaj, Guru Varga is there in Madras, some going to England, but still Prabhupada can see everything. That is the speciality of eternal acharya. Eternal acharya, though you are staying away from eternal acharya, he can realize what is there inside your heart. Everything you can realize, what is happening inside you, what kind of pain you are getting, and accordingly he is going to give response sometime, speaking Harikatha, so that you can get some consolation, some power this way. So, some of our Guru Varga gone to England, some gone to German, some gone here and there, but they are all within the range of Prabhupada. Within the range of Prabhupada, Prabhupada can see and control everything. Provided there is one condition, that you are inclined. Only one condition we expect. We don't like to see your beautiful figure. We don't like to see your handsome figure. We are less interested about from you are from Brahmin family or Kshatriya or Sudra. We are less interested. We are less interested about how much education you have. Only one quality we want to see, because all other qualities automatically come inside you. According to the desire of Acharya, Sadguru Vishnu, you can get power. Follow. What is that? Shikhai Saranagati Bhaktiru Pran. Shikhai Saranagati Bhaktiru Pran. Prana Chijar Sehetu Prachar. Prabhupada writing in Who is Vaishnava there. Prana Chijar Sehetu Prachar. If there is no life, then what use you are going for preaching? Or what do you mean? If there is no life, Maharaj, this explanation, what Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted to speak, Prana Chejar, Sehetu Prachar, Popa speaking, and Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, giving answer, Shikhai Saranagati Bhaktiru Pran. If there is no Saranagati, then all other qualities may be. It's big confusion. If I leap for infinity period and go on explaining, 100% sure, it is quite, you know, endless discussion, you see, endless discussion. Now, you know, be from different angles we'll have to think about this, you know. Though Pranacheja Sehetu Puchar is Prabhupada speaking, Shikhai Saranaguti Bhaktero Pran. If there is no vitals of your life is Saranagati. If there is no Saranagati, then you are not at all qualified to enter into devotional practice, bhakti, bhajan. Because you know, all the qualities, 26 qualities of a Vaishnava specified there in Shastra. All, you know, different kind of, you know, 26 different kind of qualities are there specified for Guru Vaishnava. But still, Krishna Bhakti, Krishna Gun, Sakali Sanchari. Still, inside a Krishna Bhakta, you can get all the qualities of Krishna to get reflected automatically. Not that only 26 qualities. 26 qualities are main. 26 qualities main. But Krishna Bhakti, Krishna Gun, Sakali Sanchari. All different kind of qualities, infinity qualities there in Krishna, all automatically come inside a devotee who is doing bhajan of Krishna, automatically. And you need not invite automatically. That's why, you know, jasyasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana sarvagunaistatro samasati suraha. A sloka I discussed na before, I already have discussed, you know. Yasyasti bhaktir bhagavati akinchana sarvagunaistatro samasati suraha haru abhakta sakuta mahadgunaha manoratin asato dhavadu bhai. As per Shastra, we can find there can be so many qualities, you know. There can be 26 qualities or, you know, all other qualities which... But if there is no Saranagati, which is the pivoted quality, which is the pivoted, you know, center point, which is the pivoted quality, which is the center point of all qualities to come in your life, or already... You have all qualities, but without this, you know, center point, I mean Saranagati, then all other qualities are material qualities. Follow, I say. Without Saranagati, if I going to off one quality, suppose you have, you know, all qualities you have, suppose, you know, but if there is, you know, no Saranagati, then all other 25 qualities, they are like material qualities. So material people can also have that kind of qualities, what it concerns to us. So this is not big point. So we should not get confusion. And we are always confused with this matter. So, Sikhai Saranagati Bhaktir Pram, the vitals of your bhajan is, you know, is Saranagati. If there is no Saranagati, so in all Mat Mandir, there should be a weak, authentic acharya, first point, under the guidance of that authentic acharya, I mean within the range of Guru Parampara, there should be nice sadhu, practicing sadhu, who going to give, you know, example, their acharan, so that common people can get some lesson, they can get some harikata from them, acharan, everything, so that the all devotees there in the temple, they can get some lesson, they can go up. If there is no such arrangement, then all Mat Mandir can become a hostel, nothing else, where only we can put one. I was attracted heavily when I spoke this way in Vrindavan, that those deities there in the temple, we are not the servant of those deities. Those deities are the same, acting as a servant of us, giving service to us. They become very angry. What do you mean? Not in front of me. Backside they are making politics. Still today they cannot do anything with me. Because I was speaking all what Prabhupada wanted to speak. They went against me many times. So many things happened. But they could not do anything against me. Because I was bound to speak that absolute, to see the poor situation in the society. I say, oh my God, if this Domomujari Sannyasi, they are going to, you know, going to show such cheap quality, then how outside people can respect, how outside people can pay respect to us? how we can go ahead with the mission of Gauriyami, Gauriyamat, how we can go with the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, how it is possible. But they say, no, we should ignore it. We should not find fault with idiot number one. This is not finding fault with others. If I am speaking about absolute truth, standing on absolute platform, then it is not bad. It is good. If I am going to make some acting and myself not doing, then it is very bad. It is not that those darshan, it is not finding faults. If Gurupad Padma not going to eliminate all the anartha from the devotees, I mean so-called devotees, Brahmachari Sannyasi, then who is Gurudev? He is not at all Gurudev. He is not at all Gurudev, we cannot confess, because he is not going to satisfy all the conditions set by Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He can show, I am a nice Vaishnava, not speaking anything to anybody. What utility? What utility then? Eh? Achi no tija sasvartham, this sloka I can discuss, and so, Acharya means you have to speak heavily. If you are not speaking, then how they can learn? They can think this is the rules. Eh? They can think this is the rules. Nobody can speak anything. One brahmachari sitting sleeping with you know woman. They know everything. Okay, no problem. Eh? We should not find fault. Idiot number one. They should go back to home. They are not. They want to prove they are more liberal. Their heart is great. But they are showing this kind of attitude out of their narrow darshan. I don't know in infinity period they can rectify their darshan or not. Because they are already again pure Guru Vaishnava. If they are against pure Guru Vaishnava, and if you are going to get their association in infinity pure, you cannot come out successful. Those who are against pure Guru Vaishnava, you know it very well. But after that, still you are going to get the association, everything. Then in infinity pure, I am 100% sure. Infinity period cannot come out successful. Because the more you are going to get that kind of association, it is just like Prahlad Maharaj, Andha Yathandi Rupaniya Manam Teo Pisichatanta Murudam Nivadya. If you are going to get and give, you know, going to be guided by a blind man, Andha Yathandi Rupaniya Manam, they want to prove in front of you all, they are so liberal, their heart is great, that's why they are not speaking anything. And then what is the utility? That you have taken red cloth, sannyas, brahmacharya, why? What is the utility? Why Prabhupada used to give this kind of titles? Why? Upadeshak, Mahapadeshak, Mahamahapadeshak, Acharya Desik, Vibhinna, different kind of, you know, Vidya, Vinod, they are different kind. To give inspiration, so that they can get inspiration to show more and more acharan, accuracy. That's why. At present, if there is any such sadhu is there in the world, somebody can know, somebody cannot know, that's not a bad. But they are going to kick him. They are going to make a politics so that he cannot show his acharan. Because it's a big problem then. What to speak about giving title, confer title to him? They are going to, you know, suppress him, down, you know, make politics so that he cannot come out. But whereas Balaji Maharaj is there, you know, because Balaji Maharaj is taking the whole responsibility of preaching, Nityananda Balaram. If somebody going against him, totally he can ruin, get destroyed. No doubt. Somehow, Balaji Maharaj can kill him, destroy him. He cannot stand. He can go and try. Absolute truth, when absolute acharan, absolute truth, if somebody going against him, up to now, there is no such evidence that after going against Vaishnava, he is surviving. He cannot survive. Externally, he can keep red cloth, this, that, with kapat bab. Now, if sannyasi coming from outside is already having 2-3 children in different, you know, still one acharya is there, he is not going to speak anything. He is going to give, you know, room to him. Okay, he can stay, no problem, he cannot. You are going to cut that Siddhanta Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. How you can call yourself as acharya? Whereas Keshav Goswami is speaking, we should do, we should show acharan in such a way, if the whole local, whole world is, you know, against us, still we should not fear. We will have to set this kind of example, remarkable example. We should, you know, remarkable evidence we should keep. Remarkable example from Srila Kesava Goswami Maharaj, you know, many times he used to explain this point. You know, what is that? Nirapakha na hoile dharma na jaye rakshani. Until and unless a sannyasa brahmachari is not going to stand on a neutral platform. Again, today is being my father, my mother. Are, why I told that day that only I don't like to fight with anybody. Only please you please give their cell phone. I can show you through investigation, I can show you what they are doing, what talking they are, what they are. Even with home, acharya, they are talking inside, father, mother, sister, they are talking with home. Are you? Whereas you leave home, you are, you know, coming here, this, you know, only cell phone, nothing else, I am not going to fight. There is a situation. So, Parampujvat, you know, Kesava Goswami Maharaj speaking, nirapekho nahaile dharma najai rakshane. This is the quotation from Chaitanya Charitamrita. We must follow this quotation, this advice in toto. Any kind of problem can come in our life, but we can ignore it, and we'll have to go with full, you know, energy, enthusiastic attitude. Because I know Prabhupada many times before, especially before leaving, you know, transcendental body, Prabhupada told, I know most of the people not going to accept the, you know, Siddhanta Vichara of Rupa Raghunath. I know the most of the people, they are not going to accept the Vichara, Siddhanta Vichara of Rupa Raghunath. That doesn't mean I can lose my energy to preach. I know most of the people, they are not going to accept it. But still, with full enthusiastic attitude, we must go on preaching about. Maybe there are some jivatma there who is very interested to get, you know, self-realization, who is interested about absolute truth. So we are with full energy. That's why Prabhupada used to speak, that though we know most of the people, they are not going to accept the Siddhanta Vichara of Rupa Raghunath, but still, with full enthusiastic attitude, we can go on preaching about. This is a Siddhanta. So, nirapekho nahoile dharma najai rakshami. Najai rakshani. Who can become nirapeksha? You can show. They can come and touch Shalagram and, you know, Nishingadev Manji. They can speak. We can get destroyed, Prabhu, if I am going to speak lie. They can speak that they are nirapekho. Having some particular, have some group. There is every society, there is 3, 4, 5 groups. If you are going to support this group, they can keep you. If you are going to support this group, you cannot say in temple, they can kick you out. This is the situation. We are going to make temple and temple and temple. Whereas Bhaktivinoda Thakur, stop making temple. Foolish number one. You cannot get control over yourself, your sense organ and everything. You are going to make temple and temple, making some garbage all over the world. You know? Saturday club, you are making Saturday club. You are making temple, man. You are going to increase garbage. There is no sadhu, nothing. Big problem. Or at all, they are speaking harikatha all out of their fanciful attitude. Many times you complain, Manajan. Why you allow your this kind of idiot disciple to recite Bhagavatam? Why you allow him? He is breaking the Siddhanta Vichara of Prabhupada. He has some ladies singing there, some Mataji singing. He is sleeping with that Mataji. And you are allowing him because he is a very famous in disciple. After that, he, you know, provide a kick on the chest of Gurudev and gone. This is the situation, poor situation. So blind. Why should we allow? Whereas it is written that we cannot, you know, we cannot approve this kind of thing. If we go on making temple, we are going to be maintaining temple. But if there is no doctor, In that case, what will happen? We are, this is the condition at present. We have so many marks and mandir, everything, but there is no doctor, or at all doctor, half doctor, which is more dangerous than ignorant people. Or if somebody having some knowledge about Shastra, he is become so much popped up. I know Shastra. Hari Baba. You know Shastra? You know Shastra? If you know Shastra, then you can never speak this way. Little learning is dangerous. Alpa Vidya Bhayankari. So this is the condition. If we are going to open one by one, if we are going to make go hospital, and there is no doctor, only patient can come and cry and go away. What use? Better you try to maintain one temple. That's why Sridhar Parameswara Sridhar Goswami Maharaj never wanted to make a temple. At all temple, then after the one temple. No, 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 no. You know, this is the condition. Because they know, bonded soul, they cannot control. They cannot get control. They can make some society. That society is also political society. If somebody not coming in India for past 5, 6, 8 years, still is going to make him member of the GBC. Because why? He is going to get vote. So our condition is more poor condition than material political parties. Very bad, very bad. So this way, if you go on running Math Mandir, never we can come out successful. We can go to hell with all our followers. With all our followers, we can go to hell. Who can stop our going to? Who can stop our going to hell? So all condition said by Bhaktivinoda, if we can maintain it, then who are you to run Gauriya Math? Who are you to run Gauriya Math? If simply we have to follow Bhaktivinoda Baba, guarantee I am Vyasasan. I can get destroyed if I am speaking any lie. Automatically, if I am going to follow Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, at least you can try. Then I can run the monk automatically. The monk can be run automatically. You need not show that you are running your monk. You need not claim automatically. Only you will have to do, you will have to follow all the rules and regulation of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, everything. And those who are out of this kind of conception, they are not at all Gauriya. Maybe they can sannyas, maybe they are acharya, maybe they are brahmachari, maybe they have billions of dollars. What it concern to us? You all can die. Well, you know? If you are ignorant, if you are not going to accept this kind of siddhanta vision, then you can die. Popa speaking, first with this resolution, Popa speaking with this resolution of avoiding asasanga. Popa speaking. Asasanga barjan koriya sadhaner unnatikrame adhikarer utkarsher proti bishesh bhabe lokkho rakhito hoy. Bengali. Prabhupada speaking with a you know resolution, with a strong resolution to avoid asasanga. If you can go on doing only satsanga, asanga, go on increasing, go up and up in your bhajan. And you will have to think about your position. You are going up or down, falling down. This way, we will have to calculate. And this way, you will have to think about how to. You will have to think, always you will have to think about how to increase your bhajan power. Increase your bhajan power means how to increase your seva mood. Bhajan power means why pure Guru Vaishnava can do seva 24 hours. Why? They are powerful. The same thing, Siddhanta is there. I am a big Hanuman, monkey, so I am a big sadhu, not there. If you are going to increase your seva mood, and going to take resolution, with a strong resolution to avoid asasanga, if you are always thinking about how to improve your bhajan, then you can go up, Prabhupada speaking, otherwise you cannot go up. Anadhikari, those who have no right to go for preaching. If they are going for preaching, then day by day whole darkness can come all over the world. all misconception, wrong siddhanta, or everything. And Popa speaking, anadhikari, those who are not having any adhikar, they are not authentic, anadhikari. Anadhikari who is not, you know, powerful, has no power, no adhikar, right, to go for preaching. When he is with, he is very clever, with very, very nice idea, he is clever, he is a businessman, a very nice businessman. You know, if I approach, sweet approach is very good, I can mold people and make them, you know, make them my servant. They like to make them, those common people, their servant. All people can serve them. Jai Gurudev, Vasalaya, lotus feet, huh? Lotus feet, huh? This way. So, Prabhupada speaking, those who have no right to go for preaching, if they are very clever, going to adopt a very dirty principle of adjustment, posroy, samannaya vat, reconciliation with this. They know if we adopt this procedure of, everything okay, Maharaj, everything okay, why you are going to find fault? Idiot number one. Is going to. And some Mayavadi speaking, we are Mayavadi actually, really so. Hey, we are Mayavadi. No belief in the Bichara of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda, nothing. Bhaktivinoda was speaking, Prabhupada, they are Mayavadi. You know, Jatamat Tatapat, everything okay. Yeah, Jatamat Tatapat, this, you know, very famous dog, you know, very famous, you know, this advice given by one Mayavadi, Mayavadi Acharya. And not, you know, they're speaking, Jatama, every path is okay. You are following this path, is Christian, is in Ishai, is, everything okay, who knows it? Mayavadi, Mayavadi. But foolish people, they are going to, respect, they are going to show their respect for them. They can never show respect to Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda. How possible? Because bonded soul always want to get some support from his guru and acharya. He is not an acharya. But bonded soul, while taking diksha from a bonded soul when going to take diksha from a bonded soul with a conception that he is guru, then always his conception is to find some, his idea is to how to get some benefit of my, out of my Guru Maharaj. And that guru, Baddha guru, he is also going to think that how to take advantage of this disciple. How to utilize him for my seva, my preaching. You know, this way, they are going this way, they are going to utilize this procedure of, you know, reconciliation. Prabhupada speaking, those who have no right for preaching, still, if they are going to follow this dirty procedure of samannayavad, reconciliation, and I'm going to follow whatever rule they like, whatever rule, in preaching they are going, Gurudev speaking to disciple, you can take prasadam in preaching it is allowed, no problem, from hotel they are bringing prasadam, it is hotel prasadam. We can kick that prasadam. It is prasadam from hotel they are getting. In preaching it is allowed. Siddha Mahatma. Very good. If you cannot maintain purity, if you cannot, you know, allow the disciple to maintain purity, how you are going to make the garbage, you know? How? You're going. Direct evidence I have. They are going to form hotel. Okay, no problem. They are very good. You know, Prabhupada speaking. They are going to allow whatever they like. Fanciful attitude. With illegal procedure. Through illegal procedure, they are going to get some, you know, get some support. And support means favor, you know, popularity. You know, preaching party in going to such a place where is there no cooker. Who can cook? For devotees, Mahaprabhu, if you like to follow Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then we cannot take prasadam anywhere. Because who is going to do one lakh harinam with full respect? That's why this condition. You know, there we can hire one cookman. Okay, you can rise very nice prasadam. You can prasadam. Your father has seen prasadam, your grandfather. foolish number one. You're going to spill sadam. You hire one man from outside, pay 5,000 rupees. Okay, for the 2-3 days we'll have to cook. You know, Krishna going to take, because Krishna is very hungry, so going to take these all dirty things. This is their conception. Oh, what to do, Maharaj? What to do? And what to do mean? Stop. You stop your preaching. You know. So this way, Prabhupada speaking, they are allowing, okay, Maharaj, in preaching it can be done. This is the procedure. So how we can expect, actual Harikatha to come out? How we can expect in the Bhagavad Sabha? How we can expect that pure Harikatha can? How we can expect pure Harikatha to come there? All contamination, everything. Analytically, if we go on judge, they are saying, if we are going to do some analytical survey, then nothing can stand. First of all, you cannot stand. If analytical survey is done, if you are going to follow, now situation out of control, you are responsible for that. But previously, when Prabhupada told Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you have to follow these rules and regulations. Those who are actually interested to take the Siksha Mahaprabhu, they can come. Not that I can bring some garbage from outside. Oh, okay, you can come. I can give to Harinam and Diksha, Sannyas at a time. One day, within one hour, I can give everything to you. You can. There is a procedure. Prabhupada speaking, those who are having no right to go for preaching, if they are going for preaching with the conception of reconciliation, those who are going to give permission for all illegal activities, all, okay, no problem. And they are going to attract pure devotees. You have no power to preach. Yes, pure Guru Vaishnava, they have no power for preaching. Because they are not pros like you. Yeah? They are going, Prabhupada speaking, to collect support, to collect popularity. You know, those who are going to criticize pure Guru Vaishnava, they are, you know, their, you know, acharan, everything. They are not liberal. They are going to speak this way. If they are going to express that kind of audacity, then in that case, that jivatma for infinity period, they are going to hell. That's why he told to take the responsibility of an acharya is one kind of curse. Not for pure devotees, not for Prabhupada, not for Bhaktivinoda Thakur, not for, you know, Kesava Goswami, not speaking like that. Try to understand why he spoke. Acharya is self-manifested. So this way, you will have to, by the mercy of Prabhupada, by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you will have to realize these points, not with fighting mood. Whereas we know, in the battlefield, we should remember, repeatedly we should remember, in the battlefield itself, Vrittasur, when fighting with Indra. Vrittasur fighting with Indra, demigods all, you know? And Vrittasur, you know, Vrittasur going to die. But still, Vrittasur speaking all about that absolute truth. Vrittasur not going to change his, you know, Siddhanta. But in front of death, Vrittasur speaking, even Vrittasur speaking so loudly in front of Indra. You know, so many tattva vigyan Vrittasur speaking. I can discuss this point. Ajata pakshaiva mataram kaga. You know, I can discuss. You know, priya piyeva vishyatam vishitam vishanya manaha ravinda kshadidikshyatam. I am not speaking now, but no time. What I mean to say, Vrittasur actually devotee, but due to cards, going to express this kind of mood. But inside, because Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, na, try to understand. Bhaktivinoda Thakur told in Kirtan, Pashupakhi hue thaki swarge va niraye tava bhakti rohu bhakti vinoda hidaye. Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, na, you can remember, Pashupakhi hue thaki, it matters little whether I can take bath in the form of beast and birds. Pashupakhi hue thaki swarge va niraye तब भक्ति रहु भक्ति बिनोद हृदये. Then bhakti is a natural function of your soul. Try to understand. You know, otherwise those cheaters, they can, you know, put some cap on your head. Topi poriye debe, in Bengali we say. Topi lagane ke liye aaya hai. You know. So Pittasur inside is Jibuti, outside expressing this kind of demonic character, demonic mood, but speaking all Harikatha. Always speaking Harikatha. Samsar jakrabhamatoha sakaramasu, you know, Pittasur speaking. Someday I can discuss, surely. So Pittasu speaking, now giving warning to Indra. Hey Indra, if you have no attraction, no attachment for, you know, material enjoyment, then you come in front of me to fight with me. Really so. If there is no Vajra means thunder, you know, Vajra, then who is going to defeat? It was made from Dadichi Muni. Dadichi Muni, you know, his you know, all, you know, was born from there, thunder, you know, Vajra was made. So Pittasur sure, I'm going to, and also Pittasur in interest, very much interested to leave the body and go to his original form, you know. Inside bhakti is there, because bhakti is a natural function of the soul. So Pittasur say, hey Indra, no chet gramma sukhes priha, no chet gramma sukhes priha. If you have no attachment, if you have no attraction for material enjoyment, then you come in front of me and fight with me. Let me see what kind of power you have. Oh my God. Vittasu speaking with full confidence, because Vittasu is sure Indra is not standing up to the, on that platform. But Vittasur is already on, you know, he like to leave body. Hey Prabhu, I like to leave this body and go to you back, you know. No chet gamme sukhe spriha mama agre tishtata. Come and stand in front of you. Let me see what kind of power you have. This is a conception, you see. So, what I wanted to speak is that yesterday also I told, and many time before also I told, but and in coming days also I like to discuss, because very sensitive issue. Very sensitive issue, and if I avoid this sensitive issue, then people can misunderstand me. You know, I have no self-interest, no smell. That's why I can discuss. If you like to leave me, okay, you can leave me. I can go and sit in some place and leave my body. Very well, very good. You know, no problem. So, but if you are interested to know about the absolute truth, and with full sincerity, then you must hear this thing. I can discuss this point, and you can remember I was speaking this sloka also, that very nice sloka actually. Achi noti yo sastartham acharye sthapayati api svayam acharati yasmat acharyasteno kirtitah. He is called Acharya. And who is Acharya? Who is going to show us all idealism of bhajan? Idealism of bhajan? Idealism of seva, continuous seva, flawless seva. Achinoti, his acharan is very perfect. Achinoti yo sastvartham, what is written there is scripture. He is not only going to advise you, you know, vacant advice, dry philosophy, he is himself going to practice. So achinoti yo sastvartham achare. Practically he is going to apply in his own life. And sthapayati api, he is very interested to establish this Siddhanta Vijaya inside others, bonded soul. They are coming to hear Harikatha. And after looking the idealism, the great adarsha, idealism of that acharya, become interested. Maharaj, you also save me, you also deliver me, I like to follow you properly, you know, Panipat, Parivesno and Seva. In that case, who is successful Acharya? Who is successful Acharya? Why Bhaktivinoda Thakur is successful Acharya? Why Prabhupada is successful Acharya? Why Keshav Goswami is successful Acharya? because they are successful to install bhakti and acharan inside the heart of other people, those who are coming in front of them. Follow, you see. That's why they are successful acharya. Successful acharya doesn't mean only he can do acharan, not going to speak anything. He like to expose, you know, goodwill, that I am very nice devotee, I am not speaking anything with anybody. Hare Maharaj, a pure disciple, a pure, you know, devotee, bhakta, acharya, is totally adjusted with the whole world. It's totally. You are not adjusted. You are speaking wrong way. Eh? You are making great aparat. So they are adjusted, but they are adjusted with, they are like Uddhavji Maharaj is totally adjusted with the soul of Duryodhan. Uddhavji Maharaj is totally adjusted with the soul of Duryodhan, because Uddhavji Maharaj knowing very well, inside the heart of Duryodhan, there is Krishna himself as Paramatma. So Uddhavji Maharaj going to show some etiquette. You know, polite attitude. Why? Uddhavji Maharaj inside heart, no, he is idiot number one. Who is going to show respect to him? Only Jive Sanman Dive Jani Krishna Adhishtan. His Krishna is there inside. So we must pay respect to all Jivatma. All Jivatma. We must respect. But that doesn't mean we can break all rules and regulation. Achara, achara and everything, external achara, achara, varnasam, dharma, we can make an open heart market of illegal, you know, illegal activities. Not that. People always try to misunderstand, you know. Jive sanman dive jani Krishna adhishtan, acharya is always respectful for all jivas. Because he is clear, he is very clearly see all jivatma. There is Paramatma is also there. So that's why they have loveful relation with all Jivatma. But that doesn't mean you have to go and kiss a tiger. And Maharaj is written in Shastra, so Jivasana, I can also go to give, you know. It's not possible. According to time and circumstance, situation, because he is Baddha Jeev now. I can respect the soul there inside heart of that, you know. But still, I must be careful about his, you know, present acharan. Because he is acting like a ghost. He is acting like a ghost, na? In temple, I am speaking about adjustment. Those idiots, they are going to explain this way, wrong way. They see this pure sadhu, this Vaishnava, is nice Vaishnava, but he has no adjustment. Foolish number one. He has no adjustment. Why? He is not going to give, you know, you permission to do all wrong activities. That's why he is not adjusted. What do you mean to say? You know? A pure Guru Vaishnava can clearly understand. He is not, she is not woman. See, he is not man. He is not, you know, enemy. No, no. Tulla ninda stuti mauni santushta jena kena chit aniketa siramati bhakti mam mens priya naraha. You can explain this sloka. Are also pure devotees, they find they are doing bhajan outside, they find they are fighting with each other. If he is going to stop this fighting, then he can get involved. But he is doing bhajan and watching, what is the problem? Haridas Thakur is never angry with Laksha Hira. Haridas Thakur is never angry with that wicked, you know, Ramchandra Khan. Never. Because Haridas Thakur knowing that directly or indirectly, everything is done by Krishna. This is called Samadarshan. It's not going to express when in the open assembly, some Gopal Chakravarti, one name of Brahmin boy, going to insult Haridas Thakur. Because Haridas Thakur is Namacharya, he is going to insult. But Haridas Thakur is never going to express any angry attitude. Whereas the whole assembly become very angry with that man. You go out of our assembly, we don't like to hear him. You are going to insult Namacharya Haridas Thakur, who is going to speak about the glories of Harinam, you are going to criticize him. Haridas Thakur speaking, why you all become angry? Because he is not in a position to accept this Siddhanta. That's why. তার কোনো দোষ নাই, তার তর্কনিষ্ঠ মন, ইন বেঙ্গল ইট ইজ রিটিং চৈতন্য চরিতামৃত, তার কোনো দোষ নাই তার তর্কনিষ্ঠ মন, হি ইজ অলওয়েজ বিজি উইথ ইউনো উইথ ফাইটিং মুড, এ সংস্কার ইজ লাইক দ্যাট, ওয়াই ইউ অল বিকাম অ্যাংরি, লেট দ্য থিং গো, ইউনো ড্রপ, লেট আস ড্রপ দ্য ম্যাটার, ওকে ড্রপ দ্য ম্যাটার, বাট উইদিন ওয়ান অর টু ডেজ দ্যাট গোপাল চক্রবর্তী ডেভেলপিং লেপ্রসি ইন ইজ হ্যান্ড লেগস অ্যান্ড নোজ বিকজ হি ওয়াজ পুটিং চ্যালেঞ্জ ইন ইউনো হ্যাজ পুটিং চ্যালেঞ্জ ইন ফ্রন্ট অফ হরিদাস, ইফ ইউর সিদ্ধান্ত ইজ রং আই ক্যান প্রুভ দেন ইউ উইল হ্যাভ টু কাট ইউর নোজ আদারওয়াইজ আই ক্যান গোয়িং টু হু মাই গড উইথ নামাচার্য হুম চৈতন্য মহাপ্রভু গোয়িং টু টেক দ্য ডাস্ট পার্টিকেল ফ্রম দ্য লোটাস ফিট অফ ইউনো হরিদাস ঠাকুর. This is the mood of Supreme Lord. Haridas Thakur, you know, our Gauranga Mahaprabhu, always interested to embrace Haridas, always interested to embrace, you know, but now he is going to speak this way, insult. Now within 2-3 days, they are going to see there and all, you know, he is going to develop this kind of leprosy, going to, you know, because he challenged, put challenge, he was, and then you know, so achinoti yah sastvartham acharya sthapayati api is a main symptom of acharya, and acharya out of his pure etiquette acharan can influence you. Suppose you are staying in America, Russia, Hawaii, you know Brazil, anywhere, it's not a big matter, but through his acharan perfection he is going to influence you from long distance. But if you come and watch, it's more good, actually. So, because you have some doubt about Guru Vaishnav, so you can catch. So, achinoti yah swasvartham acharya sthapayatyopi. Who is successful, he is in a practicing acharya. And successful acharya, how? Because he is successful to install bhakti, install all rules and regulation, acharan, inside the heart of that bandeshwar. Swayam acharati yasmat, see himself going to practice, he is himself going to represent, you know, his actual idealism, that's why he is called acharya. And also it is written in Matsya Puran, acharyastu bhaved nityam sarva doso vivarjitaha. Acharyastu, When you are going to accept somebody as acharya, you should understand this point. Acharyastu bhaved nityam, his eternal acharyaship is there. You cannot find any fault with that acharya. Physical fault or this, that also I can discuss, because long discussion. You know, drishta sabhava janitai vapuschatase, you can discuss. This I can discuss. So I am not speaking about, but acharya is always flawless. Acharya is always flawless. Not that you can rectify one acharya. If you can rectify one acharya, then he is not at all acharya. Prabhupada speaking, a guru, a genuine guru, acharya, eternal acharya, you know, acharya, a guru, who is showing eternal acharyaship. Not that you have the right to rectify your acharya. No. If you can rectify acharya, then he is not eternal acharya. Guru or acharya, guru at present who is guru, at present who is acting as guru or acharya, and he is going to demand that I am the disciple of that Paramahansa Guru, who is making me acharya? Okay. But Prabhupada speaking, if somebody is going to act as guru and acharya, he is going to express his vanity that he is the disciple of that Paramahansa acharya. Okay. But Prabhupada speaking, any such so-called acharya can never give protection to sampradaya, his sampradaya. Guru or acharya, sishyabhine matre, any acharya, this way elected, any acharya, not that that they are all successful to give full protection to Sampradaya. If they cannot give protection to Sampradaya, they cannot act as Acharya. Eternal Acharyaship is expressed, if eternal Acharyaship is not expressed inside him, then it's great danger. For some time he is going to show himself as Acharya, and other time he is going to, you know, do some wrong activities. I can give example. From Bhagavatam I started discussing, but time couldn't permit me to study. So, any guru, any Acharya, in any society, any house elected, that doesn't mean he is Acharya, that doesn't mean he has the power to give full protection to Siddhantavani, Sampradaya, Sangrakhan. So Sangrakhan, to give full protection to Siddhantavani, Acharan, is not a matter of joke. In the life of Acharya, in the whole life of Acharya Leela, there is nothing, no gapping you can find. There is nothing except continuous Hari Seva. In the acharan of Acharya, in the acharan of Acharya, we can never find any gapping. That this time he is, you know, has some gapping. He is not doing seva. No. Prabhupada speaking, all the 24 hours, even in dream, he is doing seva. It's called Acharya. Acharya is not a matter, it is not a political, you know, designation. And this, you know, title giving to him, this chair giving to him, Sabhapati Acharya, okay. You can go on doing this kind of joking and try to destroy the whole Sampada. This is up to you. You can do. I am not responsible. Up to my last breath, I am going to bark like dog. I know who is going to accept and who is not going to accept. I know. But still, what to do? I can go on barking. You know? What value I have? Eh? I have no foreign degree, I have not going to foreign, I have nothing, no temple, nothing. Who is going to care me? Okay, no problem. And no. So, Prabhupada speaking, in the acharan of an acharya, there is nothing, no gapping except Hari Seva. Because they are unique bhajan, uninterrupted bhajan, non-stop bhajan, unique idealism is the direct evidence of his eternal acharyaship, nothing else. You know. This way, what Prabhupada wants to speak, that if you going to, maybe when elected acharya for 1 or 2 months or going to follow, after that going getting deviated from the track, going to get deviated from the track, then big problem. But first, main problem in the whole world, main problem, no shortage of money. Everybody is not like Sambhava, beggar. There is no shortage of money, nothing. But shortage of one thing, that is called perfect sadhu sangha. 100% if you can do perfect sadhu sangha, no amount of energy can throw you out of bhajan. If you can get stick and if you can get attached with Guru Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, Kesava Goswami. No! The association of the saintly persons is the only way to cross over the material ocean. Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Sastha Koi, Labo Matra Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Siddhi Hoi. The association of the saintly persons is the only way to cross over the material ocean. Iha jagati sajjana sangati reka bhavati bhara bhava bhavati bhavati bhavarnava tarane nauka. There are many who aspire after the mercy of the Lord, but because of being under the reaction of some previous bad works or dependence on other issues, they were briefed of proper association and they ever did not make effort to associate with the saintly devotees. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. This only goes to illustrate such person as being under the influence of the illusory energy of Maya. Because for those trapped by material nature, the only way is the association of the devotees. You know, this way we can find also that satsanga is the only way. Without satsanga, there is no way, no other way. It is very difficult to avoid self-pratishtha, everything, to go above all, it is very difficult to go above all, you know, material interest. Very difficult. It is very difficult to go above all interest. Where we can find this kind of, you know, situation. There is the main. So, satsanga is the main way. Or if, you know, I was, yesterday I was speaking this way, you know. So, in the life of Acharya, in the life, you know, in the, you know, this, you know, Acharyaship, there cannot be any fault. Acharyastu bhavet nityam sarvadosa vivarjita. There cannot be any. Also, the symptom of an Acharya is jasho deve para bhakti yatha deve tatha guru. If this condition is fulfilled, then be sure he is Acharya. If you find he is having equal respect, even more respect is going to show for his Gurudev. Yasho deve para bhakti yatha deve tatha guru is the condition. If you can find, then 100% sure he is Acharya. 100% sure. No doubt in it. Yasho deve para bhakti yatha deve tatha guru. Because all the mystery of the transcendental world, or the tattva siddhanta vichar, you know, which you can get from the transcendental world, can get manifested inside the heart of that kind of Acharya. Yasho deve para bhakti. Also, Hayas Sirsu Pancharatravan Sastra, we can find, Yasho Vishnu para bhaktir yatha Vishnu tatha guru. Same thing, but I am speaking, Yasho deve para bhakti yatha deve tatha guru. Same thing it is written, Yasho Vishnu para bhaktir yatha Vishnu tatha guru. Sa eva acharyastu genyaha satyam etat badamite. Know it for sure, I am speaking all about the absolute truth, absolute way. It is not false. If you find he is having exact bhakti, then, you know, for Vishnu, and Guru Vishnu means different avatars of Vishnu can be there. Krishna we can speak for we are Gauriya devotees. So, Yasso Vishnu para bhakti, if you find equal respect to Vishnu, Aradya Dev, Ishta Dev and Guru, Shaiva Acharyastu Genyaha, you should know it for sure, he is Acharya. Satya Metat Badamite, I am going 100% sure. So same thing I told you, no? Yasho deve parabhakti yatha deve tatha guru. It's a symptom. Even more bhakti you should have for guru. You should have more and more bhakti for guru. Then Bhagavan Sri Krishna become very happy. Because Krishna Bhagavan in front of Sudama Viprasi, you know, I am not so much satisfied as I am satisfied by Guru Seva. Naham ijya prajatibhyam tapaso upasamenyava. Naham ijya, you know, prajatibhyam tapaso upasamenyava. Tu seyam sarva bhutatma guru susva sayayatha. Same thing I started with, na? I started with same thing, you know, what Prabhupada told? Prabhupada told, there is no such, you know, mangal you can get. No such, you know, benefit you can get. No. as you can get through Guru Seva. There is nothing more auspicious. There is nothing more auspicious than Guru Seva. There is nothing more auspicious than Guru Seva. Be careful. There is nothing more auspicious than Guru Seva. Now I think by now you are trying to understand gradually what is the gravity, what is the excellency of this Acharya, you know, Acharyaship, Acharya, so deep philosophy, you know. So you see, yesterday I was discussing, but I think today I cannot get sufficient time to discuss. Maybe I can discuss something. So in the life of Acharya, I wanted to prove yesterday. One sloka I was discussing from Srimad Bhagavatam Mahapurana, you can remember that when Parikshit Maharaj going to give punishment to Kali, Kali was crying, please Prabhu, hey Rajan, where to go? Wherever I look, you cannot stay in my kingdom. Where to go? Wherever I look, I see your influence is there. Then where I can go? Please excuse me. You know, I am surrendered in front of you. Then in that Gopal came, okay. Then Kali going to request, you know, hey Rajan, you can select some place, special place where I can go. I cannot make any disturbance. I cannot make any, I promise you, I am not going to make any. Plus, please, you know, kick me out. Where to go? Everywhere I find you are, your power is there everywhere. So please, you can give me some places, some suitable spot where I can live comfortably. So, abhartitos tadas tasmai, you know, kalaye dadau, sthanani kalaye dadau, abhartitos tadas tasmai, sthanani kalaye dadau, dutam panam sriyaha suna, yatra adharamahas chaturvidaha. And again, there is a dutopan, I mean gambling, drinking, all, you know, intoxication, women association, I mean Joshi Sangha also, in a big way, I mean complete, you know, idea we should get. Shuna, you know, jibhingsa, you know, this kind of, four kind of things are there, the Kali must be there, you cannot avoid. So, dutam panam sriyaha suna yatra dharmaha chaturvidaha. Then after that, Kali crying and speaking, Prabhu, this kind of small space is not sufficient. I cannot stay comfortably. Please give me some other place also. Then Parikshit Maharaj speaking, okay. Punascho jachamanayo yato rupam adat prabhu. Tato anritam madam kamam rajo bairancha panjamam. If after, you know, repeated requests, if repeatedly he was requesting, then Parikshit, okay. Giving space in, you know, wealth, you know, money, gold, everything, okay. And automatically when the gold and money, everything, Kali must be there. Kali must be there, we cannot avoid. Tato anritam, they are automatically lie, you know, lying, you know, madam, you know, popped up, you can become popped up, you know, calm, different kind of desire can come, you know, lustrous desire can come, and rajagun can go on increasing mood. Automatically, it's an order, you need not invite, automatically can come. Amuni panchasthanani dharma prabhavaha kalihi uttare ena datyani navasatta nideshakit. According to the order of Uttareya, mane the son of Uttara, I mean Parikshit Maharaj, according to the order of Parikshit Maharaj, Amuni panchasthanani adharma prabhavah kalihi uttarena datyani navasat tan nideshakit. According to the order of Parikshit Maharaj, Kali going to take place, you know, in those places. Okay, no problem. last conclusion there, which is most important. That's why I was bound to speak this. That's why I am bound to speak. It is written, Omuni panchasthanani hi adharma prabhavah kalihi uttareena dattani navasat tannideshakit. I already speak. I already told you. Now the last conclusion is, athaitani, that is why. Atho etani na seveta bhavushaha purusha kachit. Visheshata dharma shilo raja loko patir guruhu. Those who are acting as acharya, those who are acting as pure king, spiritual leader, they should not go for enjoyment of those things. Special indication. You can show one single instance, single example. If you can show me single example, who is not going to touch this point? That's why I was bound to speak. It is strictly written as a conclusion, athaitani, athaitani, na seveto, bhavushaha, purushaha, kachit, visheshato, dharma silo, raja, loko patir guraha. Who is guru acting as a spiritual leader, who is spiritual king, also like Parikshit Maharaj. Somebody speaking, giving wrong Siddhanta, that Maharaj, Parikshit Maharaj was bound to make mistake because he was influenced by Kali. This kind of dirty Siddhanta, they are so idiot, speaking all wrong Siddhanta. Speaking, Maharaj, when he was wearing that mukut, that crown, a crown was made of gold, and so he was wearing that crown. So and when he went to forest that time, he was losing his patience, and Koli came to disturb him, influence him. How possible? If Parikshit Maharaj is influenced by Kali, if we can say that Parikshit Maharaj is influenced by Kali, if we can say that Yudhishthira Maharaj is influenced by Kali, if we can say that Ambarish Maharaj is influenced by Kali, if we can say that Pithu Maharaj is influenced by Kali, if we say Prahlad Maharaj is influenced, then it is one kind of insultment. We are going to commit aparadh. They are doing this kind of Siddhanta. Maharaj, the crown was given by Krishna to Yudhishthira Maharaj. The crown was given to Yudhishthira Maharaj by Krishna. It was the crown of Jarasandha, but still, after touching that crown, it was purified. When Krishna going to give this thing to somebody, how it is possible that it is a contamination is still there? So how we can expect that Kali can stay there? How we can say that Kali can have a space to stay in the crown of the Parikshit Maharaj? So he made a mistake. It's wrong Siddhanta. Whereas another aparadh we are doing, whereas it is in Srimad Bhagavad-gita Mahapurana, three, four places, that in the at the time of his horoscope, when the Rishi Muni is going to represent his horoscope, or before birth, after birth, so many times, in Bhagavatam we can find, it is a remark there in Bhagavatam, Esho Mahabhagavataha. When Parikshit Maharaj going to leave body, there also the Rishi Muni speaking, this Mahabhagavat Rajan going to leave body, there we can get actual satsanga, surely, no doubt. So we are not going to leave this association, we can stay with king till then. Parikshit Maharaj can leave body, we can see, then we can go. Till then we are going to stay here, they are taking this resolution with each other, okay, we can stay here. Javad, he is not going to leave body. Then Parikshit Maharaj, because they are very, very clever, very, very, very intelligent. Those Rishi Muni, they know, now there is going to take place actual satsanga. Really so? Vasishto, Bharadraj, and Vyasadeva, Naraji, everybody coming and, decorating this, big assembly, big assembly, big assembly. of 60,000, you know. And when Sukhdev Goswami, Sutadev Goswami was again, more people was there to hear Harikatha, more. So, this way actually, we can never pass this kind of wrong conception, wrong Siddhanta, that Parikshit Maharaj was influenced by Maya, Kali. I cannot speak. Because we should understand all the Siddhanta Vichar, who is Mahabhagavat. Because common people, because they are all over the world, repeatedly, like dog, I am shouting. If I am successful to establish this Guru Tattva, Vaishnava Tattva, and the grade of, you know, devotion, then automatically I can come out successful. Nobody can cheat you. Nobody can cheat you. I am not speaking anything else. All different way for different way. So if you are going to get established in, you know, Siddhanta Vichar regarding Guru, Vaishnava, or Vivekan Sindhu, automatically you can go ahead. Nobody can cheat you. But unfortunately, nobody going to discuss about different kind of grades of devotees. Even wrong conception you are having, those who are fallen soul, they are taking the seat of big acharya, so, boy, joy, joy, Maharaj ki joy. Okay. You are giving support, but actually as Krishna laughing, they are fallen soul. So, actually you should know all the Siddhanta Vichar. Who is Kanishta Bhakta, who is Madhyam Bhakta. Today I cannot discuss, I can go on discussing for a long time because by the inspiration of Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda, I must discuss this point. You know, Kanishta Adhikari. So what do you say, Parikshit Maharaj is Kanishta Adhikari? Not at all. Who inside the womb of mother, wanted to show what is bhakti inside the womb, you know. So, who was protected by Krishna himself, you know. So, who took darshan of Krishna inside the womb, how we can say he's fallen, he is, you know, fallen soul. No. In Bhagavad Gita it is written, he is, you know, Esho Mahabhagavataha, not Bhagavata. About Parikshitma it is written many times. It occurs in Bhagavatam. Esho Mahabhagavataha, this great Mahabhagavat. So Kanishta Bhakta I can discuss day by day on these topics. Archaya meva haraya pujan sraddhaya yahate na tad bhakti suchanesu sa bhaktaha prakitaha sritaha. From Bhagavatam, 11th canto, I am discussing. Who is going to worship deities, everything? Okay. With some faith, but I have no faith for, no stable faith for Guru Vaishnava, you know, nothing. So, archaya meva haraye yah puyam sardaya yahate na tad bhakteshu chaneshu sa bhaktaha prakita sritaha. He is prakita bhakta, you know, kanishta. And who is Madhyam Adhikari? I can explain great way, big way. Ishvare tadadineshu balisheshu dishasucha prema maitri kipopeksha yah karati samadhamaha. Ishvare tadadineshu balisheshu dishasucha prema maitri kipopeksha yah karati samadhamaha. Who is Madhyam Adhikari? Who is keeping balance? Very nice. With, you know, Ishvare tadanineshu balisheshu, Ishvare prem, maiti, friendship with devotees, those who are actual devotees, and those who are, you know, going to show kipa, those who have some honest inquiry, fallen soul, but honest inquiry, okay, then okay. And those who are against pure Guru Vaishnava, he should avoid them. Kipopeksha, Ishvare tadadineshu balisheshu dishasucha prema maitri kipopeksha. I can explain big way next day. Yah karati samadhamaha. Or who is Uttam Adhikari? Who is Mahabhagavat? Sarva bhuteshu yah pashyet bhagavat bhavam atmanaha bhutani bhagavat bhagavatta atmanesha bhagavatottamaha. sarva bhuteshu yah pashyet bhagavad bhavam atmanah. Anywhere he is going to look, he is going all. Yesterday I was speaking, na, you know. Everywhere you can say, jahan jahan netro pare, tahan krishna spure. Jahan jahan netro, wherever you look, you can see your ishtadev. I was singing, na, that Tulsidas is speaking. Siyaram, I was speaking, na, this way. So this way, Mahabhagavat can see everywhere, omnipresent. Krishna is there everywhere. Bhutani Bhagavata, Bhagavati Atmani Esha. Inside himself, inside anybody, he is going to see your Ishtadev. Bhutani Bhagavati Atmani Esha Bhagavatottama. So many. And also, I can explain next day, not the, you know, not today. No time cannot permit. It is written that grihitvapi indriyair arthano jona deshti nahrishyati vishnurmayamidam pashyan sa vai bhagavatottama. Who is going to see everywhere? Bhagavad Maya. That's why they are fighting with each other. Maya. And who is going to accept things which is, you know, as a prasadam in his life to protect body. But Maya cannot touch him. Grihitvapi indriyair arthano. He is going to take sweet ball, but not going to, you know, put some influence of Maya. Maya not going to. Grihitvapi indriyair arthano jona deshti na hrishyati. Like Parikshit Maharaj, Ambarish Maharaj, Prithu Maharaj, you know, Janak Maharaj, Yudhishthir Maharaj. They are less interested about material enjoyment. But still, they are sitting in big throne, putting a golden crown, wearing nice clothes, everything like king, you know, everything. But they are accepting everything as prasadam. Grihitvapi indriyair arthano yo na deshti na hrishyati. Is not going to hate or expressing some enjoying mood. He is knowing that everywhere Vishnu Maya. Everywhere. Vishnu Maya, Ananta Maya. Vishnu Ramaya Midam Pasan Savai Bhagavatam. Even when some Rajaguni Tamaguni people fighting with each other, when a pure sadhu is there, he is looking and laughing because he can find no problem. He can say that Rajo Tamo Satoguns did different you know qualities of Maya, the three modes of nature fighting with each other. Sato, Rajo Tamo. Suppose now five big fighting going on. Rajo Tamo. One is Rajo, one is Tamo. But his sadhu is very peaceful, tranquil. Because you know, Guna Guneshu Vartanti Iti Matya no. Sajjati Buddha. Those who are really intelligent, they are not going to get involved in this kind of material fighting. So naturally, if Duryodhan is going to kick out Bidurji Maharaj, Bidhi Maharaj says, okay, you need not kick me, I myself going on. That's why pure devotees, they cannot get any space in your society. Because you are going to kick them, they are going to, okay, no problem, I know, no, don't need any patishta, nothing. Why should I stay there to fight with them? Anyway, they are not going to obey me. Duryodhan going to throw Bidurji Maharaj out of Dashi Putra. Is you know maid servant is you know son. This kind of you know heavy insult. But still, Yudhishthira Maharaj, you know, still Bidurji Maharaj not going to you know feel sorry. Not going to, you know, no reaction there. Bidhi Maharaj know it very well. You know, because Duryodhan is, you know, Tamagun, Kali. So what I can expect good from him? Okay, let him speak. Anyway, Yudhishthira, you know, Bidhiji Maharaj has no place in Rasava. Whole, because, why? Why? Why Bidhiji Maharaj no place? Because he is not going to support Duryodhan. All his life, Bidurji Maharaj is going to give nice advice to on the blind Dhritarashtra. Rajan, you should follow this procedure because this is illegal. This is illegal. Rajan, you should not follow this procedure. All the way, whole life, Bidurji Maharaj is going to give nice advice to on the Dhritarashtra. But on the Dhritarashtra is really blind. Blind in heart. Outside blindness is still okay. It's blind at heart. So, Yudhishthira Maharaj sometimes used to speak, hey, you know, on the Dhritarashtra, well, I know your advice is very good. Still, I cannot accept. It is a Maya. Whole life, Vidurji Maharaj giving nice advice, Rajan, you should not go, it is illegal. It is sinful. Rajan, you should not do it. You are going to obey your son. Then ultimately, why Vidurji Maharaj not going to get in his place in the assembly of Duryodhan? Because he was going to speak about that absolute truth, absolute way, standing on absolute platform. That's why at present, if any sadhu is going to speak absolute truth, absolute way, no society, there is no place for that sadhu. They like to avoid him, very good. That sadhu also like to avoid him whole life. They don't like to see their face, very good. Okay, if by the mercy of Nityananda, if Nityananda want to preach, if Nityananda Baladev want to preach through me, anyway, without any penny expense, I can preach. Without even a single penny. Whereas, you know, billions of dollars people are spending for preaching their own dogma, not Siddhanta Vichar. Whereas, I am not going to spend even a single penny. If it is the desire of Nityananda Balaram, the great original guru, if it is the desire of Prabhupada and Bhakti, nobody can stop me. Nobody can stop me. They can try to stop and see the consequent. Nobody can stop. I can go on speaking up to my last breath, you know. So, whereas the symptom speaking that Parikshit Maharaj can never become angry simply because he was not given honor by Samik Rishi. It cannot be the reason. Because he is Mahabhagavat. Tulla ninda stuti moni santushta jena kena chida ani keta sthira matira bhakti man pe me priya naraha. So he cannot become angry simply because that sadhu doing bhajan, closing his eyes, and not going to say so respect to Parikshit. Not that. Not that by Parikshit Maharaj asking for water and Samik Muni not paying attention to his request, that's why he became angry. Not that. What is the Siddhanta? Kali was not at all successful to put influence inside the heart of Parikshit Maharaj. It cannot so happen. Not. Then we will have to throw Bhagavat. It cannot so happen. Wrong Siddhanta. What can be the reason? The Siddhanta is that it is the arrangement of Jogamaya. It is the arrangement of Jogamaya. By the arrangement of Jogamaya, by the inspiration of Jogamaya, Parikshit Maharaj was going to show some instability for the time being. You know. Parikshit Maharaj was bound to show, because it was the arrangement. Because if Parikshit Maharaj not doing this way, you know, then we cannot get the scope to project the glory of Bhagavatam. So Parikshit Maharaj going to do some mistake. It is one kind of acting. It was the arrangement of Jogamaya. So after that, we can get the scope and who is going to invite Sukhdev Goswami, the Paramahansa Sastra? Who is going to invite? Nobody going to invite. By the inspiration of Supreme Lord, Sukhdev Goswami already reached that place by the inspiration of Supreme Lord. And there is, you know, we can see there is big assembly of Bhagavad Katha. That's why today we can have the chance to discuss all this thing. So it was not perfect Siddhanta. It is not perfect Siddhanta. That Kali was successful to put influence inside the heart of Parikshit Maharaj. It cannot so happen. It is the enemy in the Jogamaya. If it is so, then why Parikshit Maharaj immediately after going back to his kingdom and crying and speaking, oh my God, today I have done wrong. Today I have done wrong. Never before I was bound to do this way. Why I do it? I do not understand. You know? Never before in my life, I was all along be respectful to Sadhu Guru Vaishnav, Rishi Mani. Why I was bound to do this kind of mistake this today? Ish, How it is possible? And by the mercy of Krishna, by the mercy of Prabhu, today if I am going to get proper punishment, then it can be neutralized. Otherwise, I am going to lose my bhakti. Parikshit Maharaj himself expecting, I should be given punishment by the Supreme Lord. Really so? Really so? So, the son of Samik Muni, he was bound to give curse, and that curse, this sentence, you know, what he spoke, you know, within 7 days, Parikshit Maharaj going to die by the bite of Takshak, the topmost, you know, poison is there. Parikshit Maharaj then expressing his very, very nice mood. Very good, very good, very good. Today I am going to get nice punishment, so it's good. That's good. Then it's very good. So any arrangement in the life of a Mahabhagavat, they are going to accept this as the blessings of Supreme Lord. I can discuss this point once again, more and more I like to discuss, but excuse me, I couldn't touch this point, you know. Bhakti pareshanu havo virakti ranna trachayishoti ekakalaha prapadyamanasyo yathasanatah shutushti pushti khutapayonu ghasam. I can explain this sloka, not today, next day. So, Sujanarbudaraditopajogugam jugadharmadurandara patruvaram varadavayadayakapuyapadam pranamamishadapabhupadupadam 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 vanchakalpadurvasikipasindhubhavacha patitanam pavanabhavishnabhyo.